Hey, what up, guys? How you doing? It is me, Lasty, here. Welcome today to a brand new episode of the FIFA 23 Ultimate Team Road to Glory, episode number 326. Now, today is going to be a slightly different one because, well, I'm sure you will have seen that the grind stopped there for a little bit with the introduction of some overpriced 84 and 85 by 10s and then the removal of them. So if you enjoyed today, do me a favor and hit the thumbs up button. I'd love to see 1,000 likes and, of course, subscribe to the channel as well if you're new. So to paint the picture, to set the story, obviously on Tuesday, last night, I spent half the day away going to this Reading away match. So I needed to get this video done or recorded on Monday. So I take you back before 6 p.m. on Monday night when everything changed and they released the expensive 85 times 10s and stuff. So what you will see is some of the old school 84 times 10s. I'm sure by the time you're watching this, they've been reinstated, or at least I hope they have it, you know, so that you can do the grind again. But where I start is from being completely and utterly broke. I couldn't even afford a preview pack, so I had to sell some stuff in the club in order to buy the preview pack because it had two position modifiers in it, and they go for 4.5k each. So we actually ended up getting a TOTS in the next preview pack. So trying to just basically build the coin balance up a touch because we were flat broke. Figure out, I mean, at this point, I had no idea that they were going to adjust the 84 times 10s and stuff. So I can quite happily grind them for the first half of this video. And I figured what I would do is I was going to grind them out so that I could open up some player picks. So some Icon player picks, some Futties player picks. And also, I don't know if it's still working. I'll have to see. But bronze pack method was profitable. 100% pure profit, no doubt about it, whilst I was opening a few of those. So, you know, we've gone from like 4,000 coins or whatever we started the episode off on up to 35,000 just from selling a few bits in the club and doing a little bit of bronze pack method and a couple of profitable preview packs. So not bad. That gives me hope for, you know, I said I kind of wanted to start like a start doing like a one of those timed road to glories. Well, if bronze pack method is profitable, I don't know if it will be now, because those new daily bronze and silver ones that you can do loads of times might mean that people have a lot more access to bronze and silver cards. But if it is profitable, it gives you an easy start, doesn't it, to the start of a brand new no money spent account. So let's go ahead and submit whatever dupes and whatever high-rated extra cards we've got. They're going to go into SBCs like this. So this is the 93-plus Icon player pick. What are we going to get? I'm hoping for Hullet. And I end up getting the left-wing Samuel Eto'o, actually the one that I haven't got and I've never seen. I didn't even realize this card existed. So I'll gladly take that. I didn't realize. Well, actually, yes, I did realize that it was a little bit like the RVP, where it had a couple different cards. But I actually thought it was a striker or a cam. So interesting. Either way, we've gone and got ourselves a 96 Eto'o. So we've got the collection now of those two players. Nice one. And it's time to once again start for the next Icon player pick or the next Futties player pick, whatever one it is that I'm going for. I may not have decided it at this point, but so where we're at now, you can get 10 bronze, silver, and gold daily upgrade SBCs. And the bronze ones, obviously, you put 3 bronzes in for a jumbo, like 24 bronzes out. And you could do that 10 times. And then you could do the same with silvers. So bronzes and silvers now are like, we're getting an absolute plethora of them in the club. So what I think I'll do now, and of course that translates into basically unlimited golds, because you can then do, you can still do the 10 daily gold upgrade SBCs, and that gives you loads more golds. But then the ultimate silver upgrade, And the ultimate bronze upgrade, you can turn those extra bronzes and silvers that you've got every day, which you'll have loads of. You can turn the bronzes into silvers, the silvers into loads of those golds. And you will, yeah, it's basically giving you a really, really, a much more supply of the gold players, those low-end gold players that maybe you were running out of, and you got to the point where you were doing like... putting like silver players into 84 by 10s and stuff. I don't think you'll have to do that anymore. So the second icon player pick wasn't quite as successful. We end up getting ourselves a 95 duplicate Figo because I didn't want to take a lower rated card. I figured, hey, I'll put him straight back into something or other. So yeah, that was unfortunate. A little while later, yet another Donnarumma pops into the club, signaling that we need to put a squad together for something. And this time I'm going to go for the 94 plus shapeshifter or Footy's player pick. But we're hoping, obviously, well, I was going to say we're hoping to get Footy's cards. But if a 98 Van Dijk was to appear can you get the icons in this? If a Pelé was to appear or something, I wouldn't be mad about it. I'll tell you that. So that's the next grind. There's a few more icons that I've got to work on, and a couple, you know, like Mudrik and Nakata, and who's the latest one that I saw last? Odegaard. So I've got a few players to work on and stuff, but for me, that's now going to have to wait until I can get back on the old 84 and 85 by 10s. Like I said, hopefully by the time you're watching this, they will have been re-released. Because I think EA took them away after about 2 hours of being out, and said that there was an issue or an inconsistency with the requirements. So I guess they knew they did wrong, or they knew that they listened to a massive community backlash on that one, because people were like, well, that's FIFA done. I was about to finish the RTG because what was the point? Anyway, here's our player pick. And actually, we get a really good one. I get 96 Griezmann, who I've not yet packed. And of course, is not really available now. He's one that's sort of just sit there in the background that you can only get from player picks like this. So yeah, welcome to the club, Griezmann. He is about 450k, I think it was. So still a fairly desirable card. And it means that I can do something with my Tots Griezmann now that was a rare one in itself to pack. So, yeah, nice one. I was super happy about getting that Antoine Griezmann. It was a card that I'd forgotten about and hadn't really got on my radar to add to the collection. But since he popped up and he was the only non-dupe, hell yeah, we're going to add him to the collection because he's always really good on FIFA, is Griezmann. So no matter what those stats are that he's got, I bet he's one of the best strikers on the game. He would go toe-to-toe with anyone, really. So I think we end up trying to complete this SBC again because it gave me a good one this time. Maybe it can give me the Neymar or the Mbappe or the Ronaldo that I so desire. Oh, no, not quite. But actually, Xavi Simmons is a desirable card for me. For some reason, every time I got his Tots, I really wanted to keep it. And then I remembered that actually he's got a better card. And now that we've packed that, I don't think it's very expensive. But it's certainly a card that I want in my club. So welcome to the young Dutch maestro. Of course, we now have some player picks. I think we had player picks last week, but they were 82 plus. And they required a little bit more than normal. But these 80 plus ones are back, 1 of 4. They require 10 non-rare golds. So that is, yeah, super simple to get done. Especially if you want to open a load of player picks, right? You can do it by doing the daily bronze, daily silver, daily gold, ultimate bronze, ultimate silver, turning all of that stuff into non-rare golds. And you will have so many to stick into player picks if that's what you want to do, that you'll be able to build an absolute mountain of them every single day as well. That's repeating. So, yeah, you know, you can have a lot of fun with some player picks if you're just trying to get some of the higher rated cards that are still currently out. So there's an icon pick for you. Unfortunately, I mean, this is just a 90 plus one, so I didn't really expect much, but unfortunately, didn't give me the Hullet. Hullet is really the one that I'm after, or a version of Pelé. I'd quite like a Pelé. But yeah, that hasn't happened yet. So we shall see. And also another way to make coins, ladies and gentlemen, especially with the plethora of golds that are out right now that you can get untradeable, is to do the daily team of the week SBC and then just discard the player. There's 30,000 coins available to you for 382 rated squads. So easy enough, isn't it? If you're trying, if you're a little bit far off the, you know, if you're 30-40k off of the 400k pack that you're trying to open again, and you don't know how to get the coins, well, there's a way. So yeah, plenty of stuff that you can do on this game to still make the bare minimum of coinage to get yourself up to that next promo pack in the store. So here is 12 player picks that I just randomly managed to build with, I think, 75, 76, and 77 rated golds that I had left in the club. And that was after, actually, I'd done a whole bunch of the... Or was this before or was this after? I don't know. I sent a whole bunch of players into the footies crafting upgrade as well, because I wanted to see... It costs exactly the same as this, I think. Yeah, it's gold players. And obviously with this, you get one player out of it each time. And with the footies upgrade thing, you get 380 plus players. So I was wondering what would be best, you know, just to get one player, but you get the choice of four. So, you know, a good player is quite likely, or whether or not you just get tots in every single one of those footies player packs, which in the crafting packs, which is not the case, as I have found. But even some of these player picks are still pretty meh, getting the odd 82s, 83s, that sort of thing. I mean, that's just not great when you're seeing all golds in basically September. But we can end with a tot, so we can get ourselves another duplicate Kolo Muani. But I wanted to put all of this stuff into another icon player pick anyway, so I just took him, stuck him straight into the 88 rated squad. The 90 plus icon SBC is literally an 86 and an 88 rated squad, fully repeatable as many times as you want. So if you're stuck with anything to do, but like a hullet is the last thing that you're looking for, then you can just shove all of your repeatable fodder into this SBC over and over again. See if you can finally get lucky. Surely at one point it will happen, right? Unfortunately, this time around, nothing great. We get ourselves the 95 Rijkaard that we've had plenty of times. And I thought, you know what? I'll do it once more for the vid. I can get rid of that Tots Griezmann, no worries, because we've got the pink footies version now. And it's super cheap. It feels really easy to do this SBC. We're so used to doing like 16 section icon SBCs that a little 86 and an 88 rated squad for a two-parter is so quick. You get your reward so fast out of that. So what icon are we going to get to end the video? Actually, we end up getting Fernando Torres, which is quite fun. I know he's got an SBC out, but I just won't bother completing that now. I've just got him right here, so he can go in for the collection. Unless is there a better Torres? I don't think there is. I think that's the best Torres that's out. So he could go in the collection. And these are like the major pulls that we've had from today's episode. So maybe not quite as good as previous episodes, but considering we've done most of this without 84s and 85 times 10s, we've done all right, you know, we've done all right. And this shows you that there is actually a way to grind without them by doing player picks and stuff to get your fodder, because the golds are really, really, really attainable right now. But ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching today. If you have enjoyed, do me a favor and hit the thumbs up button. I'd absolutely love to see 1,000 likes on this video. Hey, that's 12:30. That means my video from today has just gone live. Well, yesterday for you lot. But I am now about to leave for Reading, so I had to get this video done in advance. Subscribe to the channel as well if you're new. Cheers, and follow me on social media. Have a great day, everyone. Take it easy, stay safe and healthy, and I'm very much looking forward to catching up with you again tomorrow. Peace.